While presenting the ministerial police statements of the financial year 2023-2024 for the entity, the Inspector General of Government, Betty Olive Namisango Kamya, made a call to the country to rally behind in the fight against fake academic documents in the country, which according to her is becoming a national epidemic. Kamya says many people have used the fake documents to secure jobs in government and they have to move fast to weed them out of public service.
Also received very many complaints and whistleblower information about people holding fake certificates. And our investigations largely confirm that.
She cautioned the public that they must get concerned and join the fight against fake academic transcripts because bearers are a danger to society.
You should worry which vehicle you are entering, whether the driver has a genuine certificate. So if you know that he doesn't, it should come out. People should worry.
Members of the Legal Affairs Committee appreciated the concern and called for more funds allocated to the Inspectorate of Government to crack the whip.
The issue of forged documents need a serious focus.
There are institutions of learning admitting students who even don't qualify for some courses, for example, engineering, medicine.
In the current financial year, the Inspectorate of Government has been able to investigate 16 high-profile cases, 508 other cases of corruption in public institutions, prosecuted 30 cases and registered a conviction rate of 53%. The IG has recovered 4.6 billion shillings from corruption in the same financial year. Kamya has dispelled rumors that the president stopped police officers from declaring their wealth to the IGG, saying he only guided on the procedure. Meanwhile, in a world where corruption is constantly evolving and becoming sophisticated, anti-graft agencies are expected to deploy a wide array of tactics. However, appearing before the House Committee on Legal and Parliamentary Affairs, the Inspectorate of Government observed that a significant number of their staff lack requisite skills and technical aids to detect and dismantle entrenched corrupt practices in government offices.
Corruption has become complex and is increasingly becoming complex, and this is of a particular concern to the entire nation.
While presenting the ministerial police statements of the financial year 2023-2024 for the entity, the Inspectorate of Government informed legislators that corruption has taken another twist of grand syndicate involving a network of corrupt officials from government departments.
It was limited to favors, bribes. It now encompasses grand syndicated corruption, where controls are deliberately circumvented in a systematic way involving a network of corrupt officials.
The Inspectorate of Government budgetary allocation for the financial year 2023-2024 is 86.4 billion shillings, disaggregated as a wage at 27.9, non-wage as 35.1 billion shillings, and the Government of Uganda Development at 23.3 billion shillings. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.